Now, next situation for place of supply of goods. Goods are assembled or installed at site. This is very simple, quite logical. Say a machine or a big plant is erected or assembled at site. Then what will be the place of supply? The destination finally is that site, the place of such installation or assembly. Say A is a buyer of machine and his office is in Mumbai, and the supplier of his machine is in Delhi. So from Delhi, Mr. B, who is a supplier, he is supplying the machine. But where the machine A require? Not at his office, but machine is to be installed at his factory at, say, Surat. So the goods where they are assembled or installed finally, the machine where it is installed finally is at Surat. So place of supply will be the place of installation of machine, that is Surat. Very simple, very logical provision. Then goods are supplied on board conveyance. The place of supply, location at which such goods are taken on board. Say for example, there is a flight from Mumbai to Delhi. Goods are taken on board, obviously on Mumbai. In that particular flight, there are some beverages, food that is to be served. So before the flight moves from Mumbai, that must have been taken on board in Mumbai. So location at which such goods are taken on board will be the place of supply of such goods. So for this particular goods which are supplied within this flight from Mumbai to Delhi will be Mumbai. Location of supply of goods will be Mumbai. So these are the various different situations for place of supply of goods under section 10. Now under section 11, place of supply of goods where import or export transaction is involved is goods imported into India, location of importer. This is quite simple and logical, that if say goods are imported by Mr. M of Mumbai, then he is importing goods from say US. What will be the place of supply? The destination is Mumbai. So place of supply will be Mumbai. Goods exported from India, location outside India. So say for example, goods are exported to J of Japan, then the place outside India, so that can be any place where they are exported. So place of supply will be the place where they are actually exported, that is Japan. So destination based again, so place of supply will be Japan. So for import and export, there is not much of criticality where the goods are, where is the final destination of goods. In case of import, say it is Mumbai, Delhi, Madras, Chennai, whatever it might be. And in case of export, what is their final destination? That will be the place of supply of goods. So now we have discussed out of this chart the part relating to goods. Location of supplier of goods is not defined. For place of supply, if it is import-export, the destination based under section 11. And for other, again destination based under section 10, what will be the place of supply of goods. So first, in any transaction for supply of goods, what you will do is find out location of supplier, find out place of supply. If it is import export, follow section 11. If it is not, follow section 10. And if the place of location of supplier and place of supply are in two different states, call it as interstate supply. If they are within same state, call it as intrastate supply. So as now we discussed about goods, let us move to services. For services under section 215, which we already discussed, location of supplier, how to determine. Now in case of place of supply, if location of supplier and location of recipient both are in India, that is a purely we will say Indian transaction, local transaction, refer section 12, or if it is any one of them is outside India, refer section 30. So let us discuss one by one. If location of supplier and recipient both in India, means it is a local transaction, what will be the place of supply of service?